Good afternoon. Today we are going to start about the talk about the joining process. So in the previous class we talked about the engineering materials, metals, alloys and polymers. Okay, and also smart materials we have discussed about. And today we discuss about the joining process. So when I talk about the joining process, we know that every product cannot be manufactured as a single piece. Some of the products, of course, single piece can be manufactured, but not all. So the desired shape and size of these such products can be obtained by joining two parts of same or different materials. So if you take a component like a particular car itself, you can take, say for example, car, it is not made up of as a single piece. So it will be joined with n number of components to be taken, and then it will be joined. So it may be joining, may be different ways. So these parts are manufactured individually, or components are manufactured individually, and then they are going to join together to obtain a desired product. So in the car, there are so many parts will be there. All parts are manufactured individually, and then they are going to join, as a single product to obtain the desired product. For example, aircraft and ship bodies, welded machine frames, furniture, computers, and as well as bridges and the transmission lines, all electrical towers, it is not made up of single piece product. Okay, these are all with a combination of components which are joined together. How they are going to join together, that we are going to discuss now. Are all fabricated by the joining several different parts. How these parts are joined together to obtain a single product, a desired product. So based on the type of a joint which are going to do that produced, joint process can be defined as or classified as two types. One is a temporary joint, the other one is permanent joint. So based on the type of joint produced, joining process can be classified as temporary joint as a permanent joint. So if you look at this here, the diagrams which you show that it's a bolt and nut. So bolt and nut is easily can be removed. So using this spanner, I can use the remove this particular nut. So okay, so this is called what kind of joint? It is a temporary joint. This is called as a temporary joint. Whereas this welding, see here, if you look at this, this is called as a welding which you have taken between the two pieces are joined here. Two pieces are joined, one piece this side and the other piece is this side. So this is joined, and then it is a permanent joint which cannot be removed. You are going to break, you have to break that particular product so that it will be damaged. So if a product is in use for a long time and there is a wear and tear, the parts need to be dismantled. For maintenance purpose, or repair purpose, or replacement purpose. So in the temporary joint, it is going to be done like this. So a temporary joint can be easily dismantled, separating the original parts without any damage to them. So here it can be easily dismantled. So these parts, as it is joined by nut and bolt, it can be easily dismantled, or it can be repaired easily, or it can be replaced easily also, without damaging to the original product. Whereas in the permanent joint, an attempt to separate the parts, if I want to try to separate the parts which are already joined, then results in damaging the parts. So in a permanent joint, the joint is made such that it has a property similar to the base metal of the two parts. Means the joint which has to be made, it should have a property similar to the base metal which have joined. So the joint parts become one piece. So if the two pieces held together and use the welding process to join those two pieces, that is called parts become one piece right now. Now these parts cannot be separated into their original shape, size and surface finish. So whatever parts which you have joined by using the permanent joint, using the permanent joint, they cannot be separated. They cannot be separated into their original shape or size and surface finish. So it may surface finish may affect, and the size of the part also may affect because that is undergoing the welding process, and the shape also may affect it. That's why if you look at this figure, see the this has surface finish, which is the original surface finish is different, and then now obtained welding surface finish is different. And as well as if you look at the size also, it will be different because you are joining the two materials by heating, applying the heat, so that the this particular part is going to be melted. So that shape also, size also can be varied. Then surface finish as well. Next, coming to the based on the process used for making the joint, as we discussed, the many if you want to make one particular product, it has to be joined with so many components. It has to be made joined with so many components. So the joint, for making this joining process can be used. So what are those joining process used for making a joint? So based on the process used for making a joint, the joining process can be further classified as soldering, brazing, welding, mechanical fasteners like bolts and nuts, rivets, screws, adhesive bonding. These are the five joining processes that are going to use for making a joint. So here, this first figure represents the soldering process. Where this is called a soldering gun, and this is a, if you have observed, this is an electronic circuit where these electronic circuits are joined by using the soldering. And similarly here, this is called as a brazing. Silver brazing is done here. So brazing is kind of similar to the soldering, okay, but it is stronger than soldering, but not stronger than the welding. And we know that welding process here, this this is the welding process, how it is going to be happen. Of course, we study in detail because as per the syllabus, we have soldering, brazing, and welding. And this is one kind of mechanical fasteners which I am using here. This is a kind of, you know, screws which I am, rivets where I am using here. Rivet, this is a rivet which you can call as a rivet, is also kind of providing a permanent joint. Rivet is also kind of permanent joints, which you can see in the sheet metal work in the bus top roof, as well as the ISL part and all is going to be made up of this sheet metal work only, I mean riveting work only. So all the sheets will be joined by using the rivets in the case of bus bodies and all those. Okay, and even aircraft industries also, all the aluminium sheets are going to be joined by using riveting, and this is called screws, and which have screws are joined, used here to join these two shafts. This is the one shaft and this is one more shaft. These two shafts are joined by using the screws. Okay, bolt and nuts, which you have discussed already. So this is the rivet and this is screws and adhesive bondings. So if I want to join a two materials, I mean substrates, so between the two substrates I'm going to use the adhesives. Adhesives of different like, you know, gel kind of, many materials are there, adhesive bonding, but still we can use this wherever you require the wherever the application of load and stresses are applied, there I'm going to use this kind of adhesive bonding. And these are the different classification which are called as the joining process in order to make the joint. So the one by one we are going to discuss as per your syllabus: soldering, brazing, and welding. So we move to the first soldering process. Before going to the soldering process, as we are going to discuss the mechanical fasteners like, you know, nut and bolt, screws, rivets, all are called as the mechanical fasteners, are most widely used for temporary joints. So for temporary joints, these are the most widely used things, that is bolts and nuts, screws, and this can be dismantled easily, which we told in the beginning. And rivets are semi-permanent fastening devices. So the rivets are semi-permanent fastening devices, and the joint can be separated only by destroying the rivet. Without affecting the parent elements. See, the rivets are generally for permanent joint, but if you want to remove the rivets, but you can remove the rivets without destroying the parent element. Means, say for example, I am joined to join the sheet metal, so with by using the rivet, So these rivets can be removed off. These can be removed off. So that's why it is called as semi-permanent fastening devices. Rivets are semi-permanent fastening devices, and the joint can be separated only by destroying the rivet. Means that rivet which is joint for the sheets, that can be destroyed or that can be taken out, and without defecting the parent sheet. Parent elements and sheets. Generally, rivets will be used for joining the sheets only. And adhesive bonding. Adhesive bonding has generally less strength than the mechanical fasteners. But adhesive bonding is used to join odd-shaped parts or thin sheets which may not lend themselves to mechanical fastening. So wherever it is not able to lend themselves to mechanical fastening, that kind of situation we are going to use the adhesive bonding. Adhesive bonding. Next, brazing and soldering, as we know that are considered to form a permanent joints. But the for repair or replacement of these joints can be dismantled by heating. So when you soldering is done, say for example, it can the electronic components like diode and all will be soldered and it is attached to the motherboard or circuit board. Okay, so when you attach it to the circuit board, then these can be heated so that it can be removed easily. And if I want to, that diode, if suppose that diode is got spoiled, say I have to remove that diode. So if I want to remove that diode, if I just give a small amount of heat to that joining at the joining, then this can be soldered, the solder get melted and then can be easily removed off. So that's why the repair and replacement of these joints can be done by using the heat, by using the heat. So welding is one of the most extensively used fabrication method. Welding is one of the most extensively used fabrication method actually compared to the brazing and soldering. Brazing and soldering is generally for electronics components and all those they are going to use, and welding is can be used for all the components which are mechanical process and all those will be used the welding. And welding is one of the most extensively used fabrication method, which is repeated here. The joint strength obtained in the welding is being equal to or sometimes more than that of the parent metal. So if the joint which is obtained by the welding, it will be sometimes more than that of the parent metal. The strength, weld strength is going to be more than that of the parent metal or base metal. Welding is not only used for making structures, but also repair work such as joining for broken castings and all those. So sometimes even for the broken things also can be joined by using the welding. Not only for making structures like, windows, all these kind of made up of using structures. These structures using the welding process. The choice of particular joining process, how we are going to choose this, all the different joining process, among those which one I am going to use for my particular application. So depending on the several factors such as application, which application you are. Are you joining, are you making a structure, or you are going to be just joining the two things for temporarily. So it is a nature of loads also, how much load it is carrying, and how that your joint design is, what are the materials involved in the particular joining process, and size and shape of the components. So these are the factors which you need to consider before choosing the joining process. There are five joining process which I have discussed till now: soldering, brazing, welding, adhesive bonding, and one more is rivet. Mechanical fasteners like bolts, nuts, rivets, screws, all these called as mechanical fasteners. So next we'll go with the one by one, that is the soldering process. So soldering, as you know that here in the soldering process we use the solder. This is called as a solder. So soldering wire, we can call it as, this is a soldering wire, which is used for soldering purpose as a filler material. Okay. So here solder is a fusible metal alloy. So upon giving heating to this particular solder, it can get melted. So a solder is a fusible metal alloy with a melting point of 90 to 450 degrees centigrade. Used in the process called as soldering. So this solder is used in the soldering process. So without this solder, we cannot do the soldering process. In which it is melted to join the metallic surfaces. metallic surfaces. Means that suppose if I want to join the diode to the circuit board, these two surfaces, between these two surfaces, their solder is going to be a ring, and then that will be melted among between these surfaces. And it is especially useful in electronics and as well as plumbing purpose. It is especially useful in the electronics and as well as plumbing applications. And alloys that melt between 180 and 190 degree centigrade are the most commonly used. These alloys which are melt between 180 and 190 degree centigrade are the most commonly used. And solder can contain lead and or flux. Solder can contain lead and or flux, but in many applications, solder is now lead free. But nowadays they are not using the lead in the solder. The solder joints are not suitable for high temperature applications. Why? Because it melts at the melting point temperature of 90 degrees to 180 degrees centigrade. That's why it cannot be. The solder joints are not suitable for high temperature applications. High temperature application. That joint itself is going to be get melted because of its low melting temperature of the filler metal which I am going to use. That is the solder which I am going to use, which has the low melting temperatures, which is about 90 to 450 degrees centigrade. So it cannot use for the high temperature applications. And the purpose of using the flux in this case is, the purpose of using the flux is to prevent the formation of oxides, to prevent the formation of oxides on the metal surface when the same is heated. So when I'm going to heat in the presence of atmosphere, so the oxidation is going to be taken place. So in order to prevent this kind of oxidation, I'm going to use the flux for the soldering process. The fluxes are available in the form of powder. It may be of powder type, or it may be of paste type, or it may be of liquid type, or in the form of core in the solder metal itself. So the fluxes may be in the different forms also. That can be available in the different form also. Powder, paste, liquid, okay, or in the form of core in the solder metal. The filler metals are used are essentially alloys of lead and tin. So generally the filler metals used essentially alloys of lead and tin. So based on the percentage variation of this lead and tin, then we are going to be called as different names for the solders. The composition of solder used in different purposes are given as below. See here, the percentage varies between the lead and tin. So as the lead percentage is 37 and tin percentage is more, then we can call it as it is a soft solder. It is called as a soft solder. So medium solder in the sense where it is having the 50-50 percentage of lead and tin. Whereas a plumber solder means where you can apply use for the plumbing applications. With that, we need to have the lead as 70% and the tin is 30%. Lead as 70% and tin is 30%. Those kind of solders are called as plumber solder. And electrician solder means where for electrical works, small kind of electrical works, not for the bigger one. So we are going to use the lead 58% and the tin 42%. Now we discuss about how these soldering is classified. The soldering is classified into soft soldering and hard soldering. So what is a soft soldering and what is a hard soldering? So soft soldering is nothing but it is used extensively in sheet metal work for joining parts that are not exposed to the action of high temperatures. So here it is soft soldering used exclusively for sheet metal work which are not exposed to the high temperatures and are not subjected to high loads and as well as forces or vibrations. The sheet metal which are not subjected to high loads or high forces as well as vibrations, those in that applications the soft soldering process is going to be used. And soft soldering is also employed for joining wires and small parts. The solder is mostly composed of lead and tin. That's what we discussed. The solder is mostly composed of lead and tin. So based on the various percentage of lead and tin, we have discussed the different types of solders. So in soft soldering, Zinc chloride and ammonium chloride are the most common soldering fluxes used, which are quick acting and produce efficient joints. So in the case of soft soldering, I'm going to use zinc chloride, ammonium chloride are the most common soldering fluxes I'm going to use. So the soft soldering in the sense solder is going to be, lead is of 37% and tin is of 63%. So in that, we are going to use the zinc chloride and ammonium chloride as the most soldering fluxes. But because of their corrosive nature, the joint should be thoroughly cleaned. Why? Because if it is left like that only, because of its corrosive nature, it reacts with the surface and then forms as the oxides. It forms as the oxide. So that's why it needs to be thoroughly cleaned. The surface should be thoroughly cleaned. And these are to be used only for non-electrical soldering works only. The soft soldering process should be used only for non-electrical soldering works only. Now we discuss about the hard soldering. Hard soldering employs the solder which melts at higher temperatures. Soft solder operates at lower temperatures, whereas this hard soldering is employed at high temperatures, which is a range of 350 degrees centigrade to 900 degrees centigrade, and it is stronger than used in the soft soldering. Whereas hard solder is an alloy of copper and zinc. Whereas the soft solder is an alloy of lead and tin. Hard solder is an alloy of copper and zinc, to which silver is added sometimes. German silver, used as a hard solder for steel, is an alloy of copper, zinc and nickel. So German silver, which is used as a hard solder for steel, it is the alloy of copper, zinc and nickel. Together is called as German silver. Now, what are the sequence of operations to be performed? In making soldering joints. So what are the sequence of operations which are going to be performed in making these soldering joints? First and foremost thing is shaping and fitting of metal parts together. The two parts which are going to be joined, to be shaped first, to fit closely. Space between them is extremely small and filled completely with solder by capillary action. So the two parts which are going to be joined to be bring very near to that, so the space we are going to create very small, and then this space is going to be filled with the solder by capillary action. So if the large gap is present, capillary action will not take place. That's why when the parts which are going to be joined together need to be bring very near to that, so that the gap between them it will be very small. And in that small gap, this filler is going to be easily filled using the capillary action. Next, cleaning of surfaces. So first is bring the two parts which are going to join together very near to that. The gap should be maintained very small. And after doing this, then we need to clean the surface of the particular parts which are going to be joined. In order to obtain a sound joint, the surfaces to be soldered are cleaned to remove the dirt, grease or any other foreign material. So the surfaces which are going to be soldered, that has to be cleaned to remove the dirt, grease or any other foreign materials. And application of flux. So after cleaning the surface, the flux is applied when the parts are ready for joining. Then application of heat and solder. After applying the flux, then immediately you need to give the heat and solder. So the solder is get heated up and then that melted and then falls in the gap between that. So the parts are held in a vise. Why it is going to be held in a vise? Vise is nothing but it is a holding device which are going to be hold these particular parts which are going to be joined. So these parts are held in the particular vise and then heated with solder. The solder is get heated and then is going to be fill the gap fill the gap, and then we are going to get the soldering. We are going to get the soldering. So why you are going to be hold these particular parts? Because while doing the soldering, it may move. It may move because of some force applied on that. So so in order to avoid that movement, in order to avoid the movement of these parts, we are going to held together by using the devices. I mean, work holding devices. These are the four steps which are used in the soldering process. And what are the advantages of soldering? What are the advantages of soldering? The advantages of soldering are simple and economical process. It is a very simple and economical process and relatively low temperature process, because it is even it can be done at a room temperature as well. There is no metallurgical damage to the base metal because we are not heating to the melting point of the base metal, so it doesn't have any metallurgical damage to the base metal. And the soft soldered joints can easily be dismantled by simple heating. And what are the disadvantages of soldering? The strength of the joint is relatively low, because even if you take out that motherboard, you can remove easily the diodes and all without any pressure. So the strength of this joint is very low. So you can just pull out that particular thing, diode, it is easily come out of that particular circuit board. So flux must thoroughly cleaned off, because as I told you, this flux is act as a corrosive nature. So it should be very clean. It should be very cleaned. That is a disadvantage which you have. And coming to the brazing. Brazing joins two metals by heating and melting a filler that bonds to the two pieces of metal and joins them. The filler obviously must have a melting temperature below that of the metal pieces. So the filler which you are going to use, that should have the melting temperature of the metal pieces which you are going to be joined. It should be lesser than that. The melting temperature of that should be lesser than that of metal pieces which you are going to join. So brazing can join dissimilar metals such as aluminium, silver, copper, gold and nickel. So we can join the dissimilar metals also. In the brazing process, we can join the dissimilar metals such as aluminium, silver, copper, gold and nickel also. And how the brazing procedure can be carried out? So brazing procedure can be carried out by keeping that the metal to be joined clean for oxide, dust and oil. And fluxes are applied on the entire surface where the brazing is carried out. And the parts are aligned in position for brazing. The joint is heated using the gas torch with a carburizing flame. Then filler metal is added into the space where the metal is going to be joined. Due to the wetting action, in the sense, when you are going to melt this particular filler material, it will form as a liquid kind of that wetting action, in the sense, it converted into a liquid and then flows through the surface of the material which is going to be joined. So due to the wetting action of the flux, the molten filler metal fills the space by capillary action. The filler metal, upon gets heating, it fills the space by capillary action. The joint is allowed to cool and then the fluxes are cleaned from the surface. So after doing this brazing, then the joint is allowed to cool, and then the fluxes are cleaned from the surface. Then flux is often used in the brazing because it is a liquid kind of that. It is a liquid kind of that that promotes the wetting action. That promotes the wetting action, which lets the filler flow over the metal parts to be joined. It flows over the surface of the metal parts to be joined. And borax is the most widely used flux. Borax is the most widely used flux in this case of brazing. And it also cleans the parts of oxide so that the filler bonds more tightly to the metal parts. So filler metals used in this process may be divided into copper base alloys and silver base alloys. So here the filler metals, whereas the we can have the soft soldering and hard soldering. And soft soldering, we are going to use the lead and tin, and hard soldering, we are using the copper and zinc alloys. Whereas in the case of brazing, we are using the copper base alloys as well as silver base alloys. So this is called as filler metal is also called as a spelter. The spelter is usually an alloy of copper, zinc, and tin. So properly braced joints can be stronger than the piece being joined. So what are the advantages of this brazing? So dissimilar metals can be joined, and because of the lower temperatures used, there is a less problem due to heat, and the joint can be quickly finished without much skill. And because of the simplicity of the process, it is often very economical, and the brazed joints are reasonably stronger than the soldering process, but not as strong as welding process. It is better than the soldering process. And disadvantage: flux materials required to prevent the corrosion. Flux material requires the prevent the corrosion, and as well as the large section cannot be joined, only smaller sections can be joined. Fluxes and filler materials may toxic, and the filler materials are very expensive in this brazing. Okay, see here, I'll show one video working of soldering and brazing.
Sir, your voice is not audible.
This is a soldering process. So this is called soldering gun, and this is called a solder, which are going to use as a filler material. And this is a circuit board, which are going to use for soldering process. That is called solder, and the soldering gun, you can call it as soldering gun, and that is electrode, and this is a stand where you are going to keep, because it is at a high temperature, because heated at that is connected to electrical. See, it is get heated up, that filler material. And so these are the components which are going to say join, electronic components. Join to the surface after fixing it. See, a blowtorch or soldering iron constitute the equipment for heating the base metals and melting the solder and the flux. It is operated on the molten state. Now we discuss about the brazing. These are the two parts which are going to join the brazing, similar to soldering, but gives a much stronger joint than the soldering, but not stronger than the welding. So flux material is there, and this is the welding torch and filler rod. So this is the filler rod which I am going to use. These are the two things which you need to be joined. So, brazing, the base metal of workpiece to be joined is not melted, but filler material is melted. See the surface of that workpieces. See here, it is a liquid like flowing. It is kind of liquid flowing. Molten state, it flows like a liquid. It flows like a liquid on the surface of the two pieces which are going to be joined. So, filler metal is heated like this, and then forms as a. See now, it gets cooled now. Adheres to the base metal. Thank you. So with this, I'm going to stop today.